Next pattern we will work on is the pattern of jealousy and comparison. Vishuddhi chakra, throat center. The thought pattern of jealousy and comparison. I tell you, most common and unaware engram is jealousy, comparison. It starts again from the early childhood when your mother says, eat well, only then you will become like your elder brother. Study well, only then you will become like your father. Comparison is one of the most common and most unaware engram. You compare wealth, you compare in health, you compare in beauty, you compare in education, you compare in intellect, you compare in practically everything. But you need to understand one thing. God is not an engineer to do mass production. Only in mass production you can compare one product with another. God is an artist. He paints each one of you. He designs each one of you. He carves each one of you. How can you compare between one art piece and another art piece? You are unique. Each one of you are unique. All of you are not equal, no. All human beings are not equal, no. All human beings are unique. It's like each human being is a unique flower. Uniqueness flowers in you. Fulfillment flowers in you when you realize your uniqueness more and more and more. If you dig out the comparison engram, you will understand. Sometime you waste years of your life just because of comparison. Your neighbor has a big house. Even though you don't need, you waste so much of your time, energy, putting it and investing it in an house. Finally, when you have that big house and are not able to maintain it, when you are not able to maintain, when you realize you don't need that big house, you feel, oh God, 8 years of my life I wasted in this. I really needed a car. I could have put little bit of money into the car. Instead, I put all the money into this house. Now I am not able to maintain. The other day, one religious leader, another mutt head came here. He was telling, what is this, Swamiji? I heard you are a wealthy guy. I thought you will be living in a palace. But you are just living in an ordinary shed. I smiled at him and told, first thing, the idea I am a wealthy is wrong. Media has spread it. It's not true. But it's not that I am poor. I can create whatever I want. But I am very clear, this much only I can maintain. That is why I have created only this much. When I have more responsible people who will maintain, I'll create. Till then, see, without the ability to create, just because others have, and he told me, oh, just next door ashram, see how big buildings they have. I told them, in this whole Thiruvannamalai, smallest ashram is Dhyanapitam, and most visited, most useful to largest number of people every day is Dhyanapitam. Because per day 1,000 people come here to eat. You guys can see in front of your eyes. Average 1,000 people eat per day, and if it's a Paurnami full moon days, more than 1 lakh people eat with this small infrastructure. as per Tirunamalai government record, collectorate's record, second most visited place in Tirunamalai. First is temple, second is this place only. As per the official record. I made it very clear. I told him very clear. All right, they all have infrastructure, no doubt. But is it useful? You need to know the law. When you create anything out of comparison and jealousy, it will not be useful in your life. Create only what you require. It will not take even one moment for me to build, fill this whole campus with buildings. It won't take a moment. To tell you honestly, to build this campus, we have money. It's not that we don't have money. I tell them, no. First create enough of sannyasis who will maintain, who will make this useful to society. Responsible people, I tell them, no. First evolve leaders. Once the people are ready to use the infrastructure, then build. See in your life, so many places your energy and money is locked where you don't need, and so many places where you need is not there. Let's work on your comparison, then we will dig out, based on the comparison, jealousy patterns, how our energies are wrongly directed towards the wrong channels. Three major aspects of your life where you compare with others. Write down how much of your time, energy and money you invest just because of this. Write down the impact of comparison on your life. Write down three ways in which you can now express your uniqueness. Answer all the four questions. Come on. Now let us start entering into the Kriya. See, through each Kriya, I clear certain Kundalini path in your body. When in particular posture, when you do a particular pranayama, the Kundalini track gets cleared to remove particular patterns from your system. Now, I am going to clear the Kundalini pattern, Kundalini root in your body, in your system, to clear the biomemory patterns of comparison. Please understand, each Kriya clears certain roots for the Kundalini energy to move in your body to break certain biomemory patterns. So each Kriya is designed particularly to open the roots of Kundalini energy so that it can reach the brain and break the biomemory of that patterns. Ready? Sit on your knees. Please spread all over the hall. Stretch your tongue. Fold sides of the tongue and make it like a tube. Let me show you. Inhale through the tongue as much as you can. Exhale through the nose. Ready? Do not hold. Please do not hold the air. If you hold, it will become another one Kumbhaka. Then some other patterns will be broken. Don't do it. See, the techniques are sacred. Do not change even 1 inch. Clear? Sit on the knees. You can keep your fingers or hand on the hip. Fold the sides of the tongue like a tube. Inhale as deeply as possible. And exhale through the nose. not through the mouth, through the nose. Let your throat center be filled with Kundalini energy. Shiva, Shiva. Shiva, Shiva. Let's gather for next session. Thank you.